Man, these lineages just don't let up with the weirdness. Anyway, the Hadozee are basically the flying squirrels of humanoid ape folk, with skin flaps between their arms and legs that let them glide. And on top of that, they're usually sailors or pirates on spelljammer ships, giving us the absolutely marvelous phrase, flying monkey pirates, to enjoy. Yes, the recent Unearthed Arcana has given us a lot of weird lineages, but these ape people might be one of the stranger ones. Hadozee don't exactly have a lot going on in the lore department, and the new Unearthed Arcana offering doesn't exactly give us a lot to go on either. We get a bit of generic community of friendship lore that we didn't get before, but not much more than that. Physically, they're described as taller and thinner than most apes, making them a bit more like baboons, really. However, basically any sort of ape or monkey fur pattern and theme are on the table here. They also have enough fur to go around without clothes, and you'll see them with just a few accessories rather than full outfits in their art. They're curious, optimistic, and often very emotional, with apish hoots, whoops, and baring their ape fangs when they get angry. They don't often think critically about morality, they usually just want to do their work and have fun doing it. Honestly though, I anticipate that most of this lore will get updated since it was kind of thin to begin with, so look forward to a new take on Hadozees when the new book comes out. Just like all the other newly released races, the Hadozees are a lineage rather than a race. This means that the ability score increases are up to you, and the selection is all about the features. The list of features is short and sweet, so let's go through them really quick and see what they'll do for your character. Starting with your creature type, you are a humanoid, and this is standard fare, as 90% of the player races are humanoid, but it isn't anything special, though it's not going to be a detriment at least. And as for size, you are medium or small. As with the other lineages, you are able to pick between them, and unless you plan on playing a character that has a big old weapon or something like that, I would just say pick whichever kind of monkey you pictured yourself as. Oh, and grappling. If you want to be a grappling monkey, play medium. Grappling monkey and big weapons, play medium. As for your speed, your base walking speed is 30 feet, and you have a climbing speed that's equal to that. Hadozee get the full movement as well as the full climbing speed, though remember that the climbing speed doesn't give you any special capacity to climb things or anything like that. You're just not slowed down when you're climbing things, whereas other people would need to move at half speed. This one's just kind of really fun to me. You get dexterous feet, meaning that you can take the use an object action as a bonus action. Using an object as a bonus action is huge, because this means, among other things, you can drink healing potions as a bonus action. Some DMs are nice enough to let people do this normally, but using the rules as written, you're stuck using a normal action for drinking that all-important healing potion. And then we have glide, which I imagine, aside from being able to play a monkey person, will be the reason that a lot of people pick this lineage. If you're not incapacitated or wearing heavy armor, you can extend your skin membranes and glide. When you do so, you can perform these aerial maneuvers, right here, and I find the wording on this to be just a little awkward, and I expect it's going to get reworked. Functionally, this feature gives you free and constant feather fall, avoiding any fall damage, and you get to move a long distance when falling. This feature gives you 5 feet of horizontal movement for each 1 foot that you fall. So if you fall 10 feet, you could land 50 feet away from where you started. And remember, in 5e, you fall 500 feet around normally. And since this feature doesn't do anything to slow your fall, it just adds horizontal movement. Jumping off a 10-foot high wall lets you essentially travel 50 feet instantly. Now imagine you jump off a 100-foot building, you'd travel 500 feet in any direction that round and land safely. I fully expect that this is going to get completely reworked, so enjoy it and exploit it while you can. Sorry, DMs. There's no more ability score matching now with the lineages, so there's also no more real ideal classes anymore, sort of. However, the Hadozees have a couple of features that can work amazingly well with certain strategies. The Dexterous Feet ability lets you use an object as a bonus action, which means super fast trap disarming for artificers and rogues, since using your tools utilizes the use an object action. Beyond this, practically any class can make use of faster healing potions, so long as you aren't normally using your bonus action during your turn for other things. Classes like the Cleric, Fighter, Paladin, Sorcerer, Wizard, and Warlock can all make great use of it, so long as they don't dual wield or run out of potions. So this is definitely one of those lineages I'm excited about, but I'm not going to let myself get too excited about any of them, because a lot of them have some overpowered elements that I know are going to get changed, and I don't want to start building lore in my head that ends up being cooler than the lore that Wizards of the Coast releases. But I am definitely excited for them, and I don't blame you if you are as well. Even if that glide thing just... Thank you guys so much for watching this quick video. I really appreciate it. Be sure to like and subscribe because we put out new videos every week. And if you guys have any ideas for things you'd like us to cover in the future, please let us know down in the comments. You can also support us on Patreon if you'd like to. And if you plan on building a Hadozee character, I would really love to hear about them in the comments as well. Thanks again for watching. My name's Patrick Ferguson from Skullsplitter Dice. And until next time, farewell.